going to do right now is talk about how to train. Now, I know that sounds crazy, but a lot of people don't train in a realistic manner or how they're going to get the biggest bang for their buck. And if you're going to train, we want you to be as successful at training as you possibly can be. Now, the number one thing that we see people do wrong is they go too fast. So, go slow. If you've ever attended one of our classes, people will tell you that this is one of the biggest things that we harp on is go slow, because you learn so much more by going slow than you ever will by going fast. You have to have technique before speed. You have to understand what makes it work and what the flaws are in the technique, okay? Now, another thing is that focus on the information shown. Try to duplicate it to the best of your ability. All right, do not deviate from the technique shown, at least not intentionally. What we have found is that people will deviate from it simply because they're doing it wrong. But do not consciously deviate from the technique shown unless you have done it, you know, literally hundreds of times and you know that you're doing it right. All right, now, you are going slow for learning purposes and to keep each other safe. Sure, you can circumvent someone's technique because you're going slow, but that's not the point. If they were going full speed, which we never recommend that you ever do, you wouldn't be able to do some of the things that you can do at slower speeds. That goes for the attacker and the defender. Understand that, all right? Now, be a good training partner. You are role-playing. Just because you know what they're going to do, don't cheat them out of the training experience. Let them do what they're trying to do and let them learn. Okay, now I will tell you, the learning process goes both ways, okay? The defender and the attacker or attackers should be learning something all at the same time. In fact, if you are training correctly, more than likely the attacker is going to learn more than the defender, because they're going to figure out the flaws in the technique probably faster than the defender is. You know, back in the day when I first started training out for about the first 5 years, we always fought for who was going to be uke, or the demonstratee, or what some people would call the test dummy, all right? Because you learned what actually made that technique work, all right? So again, being the person who is the demonstratee or the attacker is probably going to learn more than the defender. Another thing is, people, is that speed does not equal realism. I know that a lot of guys are hung up on this, but if something is combat effective, you cannot do it at full speed because of safety purposes, okay? A lot of these guys will talk about, you know, well, you got to put a mouthpiece in and some gloves on and go at it, be able to take a shot, blah, 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 all right? That's baloney. If it is combat effective, you cannot go at full speed. Understand that. Speed does not equal realism in most things. I'm not saying there's not ever a time that you shouldn't go fast, you know, like force-on-force training, things like that. But generally speaking, slow is better. All right, now, break things down and learn each step the way that it is taught. Why is he moving this way? What's happening? So on and so forth. Where's your body in relation to the attackers? These are key things. Odds are that you're not going to get the technique right within the first 20 times or so. You might think that you're getting it right, but odds are you probably are not. Okay, I'm just telling you like it is. Now, you know, and just because you're not getting it right doesn't mean it doesn't work. We're not going to show you anything that doesn't work, okay, in most situations or even much of the time. We research this stuff and we're going to show you stuff that is simple and effective to do, okay? Now, train for at least 1 to 2 hours at a time. Now, if you're training by yourself, 45 minutes might suffice, but if you've got a training partner with you, train at least 1 to 2 hours at a time, because you took the time to get together, you might as well make the best of it. All right, set a training agenda. What are you going to train on? Now, perform the technique at least 20 times each. Now, what you don't want to do is develop bad muscle memory, so you don't want to do it like hundreds of times without being sure that you are doing it correctly or even mostly correctly. Now, there are some things that you can do that are not really going to put you in danger, okay, and you might not exactly have the technique how it's taught. But here's the deal is, you don't want to develop bad muscle memory and then go, oh, well, now I have to retrain myself. So what I would suggest is that if you're having a lot of problem with it, is that record a video question and upload it, all right? And make sure, go out there and just make sure that no one else has put the same question up. Now, another thing I want to tell you is, when you're training, never bend backwards or forwards or to the side things like that, because you are off balance, and that's never a good thing. All right, so if you find yourself going around a gun arm or a knife arm or whatever, and you're bending, that's not safe. All right, so do not do that. You want to move your body in a manner that you can be safe, and you know, there's really no time to ever be off balance. Okay, don't talk a lot when you're training. All right, train. That's what you're there to do. If you want to talk afterwards, that's fine. After your 2 hours is up or whatever time that you have set forth, talk, but don't talk while you're training. Now you can say, well, you need to step here or here or whatever, but again, do not deviate from the technique shown. All right, so again, this is really, really important. Now, we have found that most people, they do the technique 4 or 5 times, they want to talk. Well, I'm going to tell you what, odds are you're probably not going to get it within the first 20 times. So talk is cheap, actions are golden. Understand that. Now, another thing is, do not do anything that you are not comfortable with. That's the bottom line, all right? So another thing I want to tell you is, if you're training with guns, I prefer that you don't train with a real gun. If you do, put a training barrel in it. Preferably you would have a blue gun or a red gun or an airsoft gun or some sort of gun that is in there and does not work. All right, now if you're training with knives, especially starting out, have a training knife. If you're training with a partner, have a training knife. The only time you should have a real blade out is once you have become totally comfortable in using that blade and you're practicing your draws and cuts, so on and so forth, and you're actually cutting. Okay, those are acceptable times, but any other time, you need a training knife. All right, so again, these are just some simple training things, training issues that we want to present to you, and ways to train that we feel are going to give you the best bang for your buck when you take the time to train. Okay, again, repetition is the mother of all skills, so you're going to have to do this quite a bit in order to get good at it and understand it, all right, and be confident in it to use it. So again, repetition is the mother of all skill. Don't talk a lot, be safe, and go slow. As always, train hard, train often, and most of all, train realistically.